Good morning, students. Welcome to the first session of Basic Electrical Engineering ESEE 101. Here, in Basic Electrical Engineering, in first session, we will learn about the DC circuit. In first lecture, first we will go through all the detailed content and the module 1 that we are going to study. This course code is ESEE 101 and the credit number is 4 and course title is Basic Electrical Engineering. In module 1, it will take 8 lecture classes. Here you will learn about electrical circuit elements R, L, C, which are resistor, inductor and capacitor. Various kinds of sources like voltage source and current source, Kirchhoff's current law and voltage law, based on which we are going to solve the numericals, analysis of simple circuits with DC excitations, that means we use some voltage source or current source as per our requirement, and some theorems, superposition theorem, Thevenin's theorem and Norton theorem. And in the last, we will study the time domain analysis of first order RL-RC circuit. That means when one resistor and inductor is connected and one resistor and capacitor is connected. In both cases, what will happen? Now, according to our course curriculum, this is our course outcome, ESEE 101.1. Where you will learn the understand the basics of electrical circuits, circuit parameters and components. In second, 101.2, analyze AC circuits. In ESEE 101.3, discuss the fundamentals of transformers and its performance. In 101.4, establish the role of different electrical machines. In 101.5, develop knowledge in power converters. In 101.6, relate the applications of different switchgear in electrical installations. Now, in this session, you will learn about the concept of electricity, that what is electricity and how it affects our life. In second, concept of the circuit elements. In three, details and working of resistor, inductor and capacitor. And obviously we need some knowledge on some active elements. Then we will solve some numericals for better understanding, and at the end of the class I will give you some assignment which will be solved in next, before the next lecture. Okay, now let's study. What is electricity? Electricity is nothing but the presence and flow of electric charge in one direction. When there is any potential difference in a circuit, to make the difference zero, negative charged free electrons flow to the direction of positive charged protons. That means, according to our this circuitry, if we choose this circuit first, it is our battery connected. Suppose from a shop you bought one 10 volt battery. This side is positive, this side is negative, to which one ammeter is connected. What this ammeter is doing here? It is measuring the current. The ammeter will measure the current. To which one element is connected called resistor, and the circuit is in closed loop. Now, for better understanding, suppose this resistor is replaced by the bulb. So, bulb will act here as the resistor. As you can see here, this blue arrow will note the direction of electrons. As you can see, it is the electrons are flowing in this direction. Similarly, the electrons are going, this one is our positive side, this one is our negative side of the battery that you bought from the shop. So what will be the direction of current flow? The current flow will be denoted by this red color arrow mark. It is flowing in the opposite direction of the electron flow. So this is electricity. So here the current will go from positive side to negative side like this. This will be the our current flow. Okay, going to the next slide. Here you will learn about some circuit elements, or better called the network elements. These various types of network elements are divided on various basic concepts. Basis of the energy stored, it is divided into two parts, active element and passive element. What are the active elements? Vacuum tube and some semiconductor devices like op-amp. What is op-amp? Its full name is operational amplifier. And transistor is another active element. What are the passive elements? Resistor, inductor and capacitor. In previous slide I showed you one inductor that is connected with one voltage source. Resistor is denoted by R, inductor is denoted by L in the circuit, and capacitor will be denoted by C, either by capital or small c. Okay, now on the basis of their characteristics, it is also categorized into two: linear element and non-linear element. So linear element, resistor is one linear element, inductor and capacitor. Some non-linear elements like thyristor. Basically what you already read in class 11-12 about the semiconductor devices like diode. So all that semiconductor devices are non-linear element. Okay, now on the basis of the direction of current flow, it is of two types: unilateral element and bilateral element. Unilateral element is diode, bilateral element is resistor, inductor and capacitor. What is unilateral element? Unilateral element means it allows the current to flow only in one direction. Suppose this is one unilateral element. Okay, one voltage source is connected here. So this side will be positive, this side will be negative. So naturally current will go into this direction. Okay, now if I make the polarity of the voltage source opposite like this, negative and then positive, and it is then connected, then it won't allow to flow the current in opposite direction. It doesn't allow. So this type of element is called the unilateral element, like diode. Okay, what is then bilateral element? If bilateral element is connected in a circuit, then it will allow to flow the current in either direction. That means whether the polarity of the voltage is changed according to that voltage source, the current will flow either in clockwise direction or in anti-clockwise direction. Like suppose in previous slide I showed you one resistor. So I am drawing one resistor here and I attached one voltage source. Okay, so the current will flow through this like this. You can say that because this one is our positive side, this one is our negative, so current will flow in clockwise direction. Okay, now if it is connected such a way that our polarity is opposite than the before, then will it allow? Yes, because this one is one bilateral element, so it will allow. So this case happens for inductor and capacitor. Okay, now in the next slide we will learn about the what is resistor, what is inductor, and what is capacitor, and what is the difference between them. What is resistor? Electrical resistance is the property of the material by virtue of it opposes the flow of electrons through the material. So this type of element is called resistor. Its unit is ohm, and it is denoted by this ohm symbol. Okay, and in the circuit, whenever we attach this element, we will denote it like R, or you can denote it like R1 or R2, okay, according to our number of this type of element we connect in the circuit. Now what is inductor? Inductance is the property of the material by virtue of which it opposes the change of magnitude or direction of the current passing through the conductor. That means it opposes the rate of change of current flowing through the inductor. This inductance is unit is Henry, and it is denoted by this H symbol. Now what is capacitor? Capacitance is the capability of the element to store the electric charge in it. This element is called capacitor, and one capacitor stores the energy in the form of electric field being established by the two polarities of the charges, like this shown in the figure. In circuit, when we connect one capacitor, we denote it by C letter, and for inductance it is L. The unit of capacitance is farad or microfarad or millifarad, like this, and it is denoted by F symbol. Okay, so from here some passive element knowledge. Okay, now some active elements. An active element is a device that has an analog electronic filter which can amplify a signal or can produce a power gain. There are two types of active component: electron tubes and semiconductor. Now this diode, this transistor, this SCR, these are the active elements. Okay, in previous slide I already showed one diode, and I already told you that it is an unilateral device. That means it allows to flow the current only in one direction. It will allow to flow the current in this direction, but opposes the current in if it tries to go in like this. Okay, this is one transistor, and this one is SCR, that is silicon controlled rectifier. Okay, in next slide we will learn the linear and non-linear characteristics of the elements. Here you can see one circuit is here, one voltage source is here of V. You can clearly tell that this one is positive, this one is negative, through which current can flow like this. Okay, this one is R1 resistor, this one is R2 resistor. Now this R1 resistor, when current is flowing, the potential difference can be measured by this voltmeter, and current can be measured by this ammeter. Now if we notice that this voltage will gradually increase as the current is increased accordingly. Similarly, for the resistance R2, when current is increasing, the voltage is not increasing linearly. It is showing some curvature. That means it is non-linear in nature. So simply you can say that if one element I am drawing like this, and I am telling that this one is one resistor or inductor or capacitor, okay, so this will show you the linear resistance or linear inductance or linear capacitance. But if I draw one element like this and an arrow is passing through it, that means this element will show the non-linear characteristic. Clear? Now, unilateral and bilateral elements. Already I told you that diode is one unilateral element that will allow to flow the current in only one direction, and the resistance is one bilateral element. That means current will be allowed to flow in either direction. Fine? Okay. In next, here some formulas are written in tabular form. For circuit element resistance, from Ohm law you can say that voltage is directly proportional to I, and this R is the constant. This form, based on this formula, the generated voltage across the resistor can be found out. Now, what will be the current? Current will be V divided by R, and what will be the power loss? This is I square R. It is also called the ohmic loss. Okay. So basically, in DC circuit, you have to remember this type of such terms. Okay, ohmic loss. For inductor, from Lenz's law we can say that V equals to L di dt, and if V equals to our L di dt, then how will we calculate the current? Let me do it. Okay, so we can say that 1 by L into V into dt equals to di. Okay, I hope you will agree with this. Next, integrate both sides. So 1 by L V dt integration. Integration. Okay, so now here you can find the current value, that is I equals to 1 by L integration V dt plus some constant. Okay, so here the constant is written as I0. Here K is I0. Okay, what is the power loss? Power loss, voltage you already know, V equals to L di dt. And what is the power formula? Power is equals to V into I. So if you multiply these two, that means L I into di dt. That means L I di dt. Okay, then after integration you will find out that the final power is P equals to half L I square, half L I square. So you have to remember this thing, that what is the power loss for one resistor if current I is flowing through it, what is the power loss for an inductor if I current is flowing through this. Okay, Now going to the capacitor case. For capacitor, you already know that Q equals to CD. Okay. Now, what is Q? Q equals to I into T. That means if I say that dQ dt equals to C into dV dt. Okay, agree? Next, what is dQ dt? Rate of change of discharge equals to current. So I equals to C into dV dt. So from here you are getting this equation. Okay. Similarly, if you are integrating it like I dt integration 1 by C equals to V, and one constant will be added here. Suppose this one is K1. Here K1 is written as V0. Okay, this is the initial voltage. So these two equations I have derived already. You have to remember these two equations from which you can calculate the voltage across the capacitor and the current that is passing through the capacitor. Now, what is the power? Power will be P equals to V into I. What is V here? Okay. And finally, you can see that power will be half into C V square. That means if you integrate it, then this equation you will get that power equals to half of CV square. So these equations you have to remember, that what is the power loss for resistor, for inductor and capacitor. Okay, now going to solve some numericals. In question number 1, you can see that a 100 ohm resistance is directly switched on across a 10 volt battery. So what is the current flowing through the resistor, how much is the power loss, and also find out the energy consumed in 5 seconds. While solving this electrical circuitry problems, always you remember that try to draw the circuit diagram. Okay, so if I am trying to draw the circuit diagram, it will look like this. One resistor of how much value? Okay, of 100 ohm, and it is connected across a 10 volt battery. Fine. So how much current will flow? You can see that V divided by R, that is 10 divided by 100 equals to 0.1 ampere. So current flow like this will be 0.1 ampere. So what is the power loss? If you can remember correctly, power loss formula, P equals to I square R. So 0.1 square into 100, that means 1 watt. Okay. And I square R power loss you will get from Ohm's formula. Okay. Also the power loss formula is V square by R. So whatever formula you are using, you will get the same power loss. Okay. Now, what is the energy consumption for this 5 second? That is I square R into T. That will be 1 into 5 watt second. That means 5 joule. Next numerical, the strength of a current in 1 Henry inductor changes at a rate of 1 ampere second. Find the voltage across it and determine the magnitude of energy stored in the inductor after 2 seconds. So, first, draw the circuit diagram. This is the inductor. The rate of change of current, that means DIDT, is 1 ampere per second. The L value, that is given as 1. What is the unit? Henry. H-E-N-R-Y. Okay. So, what is the voltage that will be across the inductor? L into DIDT, that is 1 into 1, that is 1 volt. So, energy stored is given as W equals to half Li square, that will be half into 1 into 2 square, that is 2 joule. So if a rate of 1 ampere per second current is flowing through the inductor, the energy stored will be 2 joule. Now, can you tell me what kind of energy this inductor is storing? The inductor is one coil. Okay, so whenever current is passing through it, it is creating one magnetic field. Okay, so the energy that it is storing is basically magnetic energy. So it is storing the energy in magnetic form. Okay, clear? Next numerical. The capacitor has the capacitance of 5 microfarad. Calculate the energy stored if a DC voltage 100 is applied across it. So, all of you try to draw the circuit first. What will be the circuit? One capacitor is connected across the voltage source of 100 volt. Fine. So, what is the energy stored? If you all can recall, W equals to half CV square. I already told you. What is the capacitance value? 5 microfarad. Micro means 10 to the power minus 6. Okay. So, half into 5 into 10 to the power minus 6 into 100 square. So, it will be 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 2 joule. That means 25 millijoule energy stored. And this capacitor is storing the energy in the form of electric field. Okay. Next is the assignment which you have to solve. And in next session, that means in lecture 2, I will tell all these assignments, what will be the answers of these assignments. Okay, first, what will happen if the inductor if a 10 volt DC is applied to it? Second question, what are the types of energy stored in inductor and capacitor? Okay, third question, the current and voltage profile of an element versus time has been given here. Okay, determine the element and find its value. That means here some diagrams are given. Okay, to this diagram you have to decide what type of element will give you this type of characteristic waveforms. Okay, thank you.